guys! It's me, Allyza. So this video is for educational purposes. In this video, we're going to talk about what communication breakdown is and its barriers. So, what is communication breakdown? Communication breakdown is the failure to exchange information which causes lack of communication. This occurs when the receiver didn't understand the message that was sent by the sender. We have four different types of communication barriers. Physical barriers. Physical barriers are the natural or environmental conditions that act as a barrier in communication in sending the message from sender to receiver. For example,
oh, hello sis, where are you? Oi sis, I'm here, I'm on my way. Clearly. What are you saying? You always late talaga. Manong driver,
sakali na po. Psychological barriers. Psychological barriers are called as mental barriers. These refer to the social and personal issues of a speaker toward communicating with others. For example,
hey, Ms. Garcia, it's your time to voice out your speech. Yes, ma'am. Ms. Garcia. Come on in front. I'm sorry, ma'am.
Cultural barriers. Cultural barriers pertain to communication problems encountered by people regarding their values, beliefs, and traditions in conflict with others. People's culture affect the way they communicate and relate to others. They may have different races, age, gender. Because of that, it may negatively affect the way they communicate and relate to one another. Linguistic barriers. Linguistic barriers pertains conflicts with regard to language and word meaning. Because words carry denotative and connotative meanings, they can sometimes cause confusion and misunderstanding. Meaning of words and symbols also vary depending on culture. For example, kamusta, konnichiwa, ni hao, annyeonghaseyo. Even though they mean the same thing, we won't be able to understand it because it's a different language that caused communication breakdown. And we have vertebrae. Vertebrae gives a similar idea of barrier when he classifies noise into three kinds, such as external, internal, and semantic noise. External noise are the sight, sound, and other stimuli that draw people's attention away from intended meaning. For example, noise from a vehicle, the dog barking, and the sound of the earth. Internal noises are the thoughts and feelings that interfere with meaning. For example, confrontation with a friend, fear of speaking in front of the class, racial prejudice, and lastly, semantic noises. Semantic noises are the alternate meaning around by a speaker's symbols. This idea means that a word may have an other meaning in the minds of the student. This affected by the language in which they grow and culture in which they are exposed. For example, incorrect grammar, using excessive technical jargons, using idiomatic expressions.